Hey everybody, it's Gordon Majak here, back with a Sunday edition of Timeless Pop, Rock, and Soul. And today the emphasis is on the soul. We are going to church, baby, and I am not even joking. You'll see what I mean in a second. Before we get to the music, please remember to like, subscribe, comment, all that, etc., etc., blah, blah, blah. Let's get to the music. I can't wait. Okay. Today, we are going back to 1978 and this album. This is the third album by the Little River Band, Australia's Finest. This was an album called Sleeper Catcher. And this is the album that has a song called Light of Day. And I am not joking, we're going to church, folks. Now, I remember reading an interview with the Little River Band back in the day, back there in their heyday in the 70s, and a couple of things caught my eye about their interview. The first thing was that they said that how much they admired and were influenced by the rhythm section sound of Chicago. They loved some American pop and rock music, and they especially loved Chicago, and they loved that rhythm section sound that Chicago had there in the 70s. And the other thing they said they loved was the vocal sounds, the vocal mixes of the Eagles. Well, it didn't take a genius to figure out that Little River Band was going to put those two elements together and mix in some of their own Aussie brand of soul and pop and rock and jazz and everything else that they could play so well and come up with their own mix. And that's exactly what they did. Now, this was the third album, but the Little River Band story for me actually goes back to their first album. And that was this record. One day I was at my buddy's house and he said, "Hey, have you heard this brand new album by this brand new band from Australia? The band is called the Little River Band. Have you heard this song called It's a Long Way There?" And I said, "No, never heard of them." Well, these guys had balls this big because they came out on their very first record, first song, first side of the album with an 8.5 minute epic. There's no other way to describe it. It's a long way there. It's just a flat out rock, pop, soul. I don't know, care what you want to call it. Just an epic performance by these guys. Mixing the great instrumentation, the great ensemble and rhythm section playing with these incredible vocals, okay? Now, I had the good fortune of actually seeing Little River Band live in concert circa this album, when they toured in support of this album, the album with the song that we're playing. I actually saw them in concert, and I went to the concert knowing that they were a good band. Obviously, they'd had these three albums out by then. The first album with It's a Long Way There, the second album from 1977, Diamantina Cocktail, which had Help Is on Its Way and Happy Anniversary and Home on Monday. So many good songs on that album. And then this was the third album, Sleeper Catcher, which had the big hit Reminiscing, which I think was a top five hit for Little River Band. This song Lady, which was a big hit, top 10 hit, I think, for them back then. So they obviously managed to do exactly what they had said they might want to do musically in terms of combining these different influences into a really beautiful and really unique mix. And so when I went to see them in concert, I knew all of that. I knew they were great. But I have to tell you, I was already a fan, but I was not prepared for the actual level of musicianship in concert, and in particular, those vocal lines, the vocal, the ensemble vocal work, both the lead vocals and the harmony vocals. Yeah, I saw the Eagles live several times in the 70s. I know how good their vocal mix was. Okay, I saw the Bee Gees live. I know how good their vocals sounded. I saw a lot of the really good pop and rock vocal groups. Okay, and I'm just saying I was not quite prepared for how strong and how tight and how just incredible the Little River Band their performance top to bottom was, but their vocal mix, oh my God, they have a vocal mix. Sort of like, I guess you could say, with the Eagles, when the Eagles had Don Henley and Randy Meisner on the top of that vocal stack. Boy, Little River Band, there's a certain mix there where they get those harmony vocals going, and then Glenn Shorrock, their great lead vocalist, comes in on top of that. And that signature sound is just so unique, and it's so perfectly them, and it's so beautifully done. So let's go to church, right? This is 1978 when this album came out. I was already a big fan. And I just remember hearing, again, here's an 8-minute cut. So I'll have to pause it somewhere there in the middle. Here's an 8-minute cut. And I just remember hearing this album and then hearing this song. And I was already a fan, but I just, it was sort of reminiscent, as I said, of that other bookend, that epic at the beginning of their career, just a few years previous. It's a long way there. But this one just so uniquely beautiful and powerful and spiritual. And I don't want to even overstate it. I just want you to hear this song, folks. From 1978, Little River Band, Australia's Finest, and a really, what a message in this song. Listen to these lyrics, folks. Light of day. Thank you. see what I mean about these vocals? They've got that blend that is so uniquely and perfectly them. And when they hit those harmonies and Glenn Shorrock comes in on top of that mix, oh my God. Just such an epic vocal sound. And listen to this rhythm section. David Briggs on the guitar and George McArdle on bass. Listen to these funky brothers from Australia.
Yeah.
As incredible as that is on the album like that. So there I am in concert watching them do this. And like I said, I was already a huge fan when I walked in the door, but I was not prepared for these brothers to throw down the gauntlet like they did, both instrumentally and vocally on this song. I mean, I'm not even joking. These guys, they never got the due as musicians, certainly, and as singers that they deserved based on however many pop hit songs they had. But let me tell you, and let's be clear about the particular lineup, because Little River Band is a group that had some personnel changes along the way. So let's be crystal clear that when I talk about Little River Band, I am talking about the classic lineup from 1977 in the Diamantina Cocktail album to 1978 with this album, Sleeper Catcher. The classic lineup, which we have identified as George McArdle on bass. You heard George's fretless bass solo there during that song. Oh my goodness. David Briggs on the lead guitar. That was David stretching out on this song. Beeb Birtles on guitar and vocals, and he was also the composer of this song. Graeham Goble on guitar and vocals, also a primary composer in the band. Derek Pellicci on drums for these two albums. And of course, the great charismatic front man, the one and only Glenn Shorrock on lead vocals. And what a performer he was, and what a band. And I got much more than I bargained for when I went to see them in concert. These guys could play. Wow. And there it is, a little Sunday trip to the altar to pay our respects. Little River Band, Light of Day. They certainly didn't have much of a challenge weaving their beautiful message of faith and salvation, I guess, however you might like to parse their beliefs. But they sure didn't have any problem weaving it into this song because it's just right there up front and so beautifully and tastefully and exquisitely done. From 1978, The Little River Band and Light of Day. Wow. The song still just gives me chills after all these years, and I think of seeing them do it live, and it just, oh my goodness. Thanks, guys. See you soon, back with another video, hopefully a little bit later.